Okay, so we're inside working on a little kitchen project, you know, cooking with the German, and I don't even know if I'm fully in the frame. I think you can see the stuff down here, but the camera's basically glued up on the wall, and I wish I could show you what that looks like because it's ridiculous. So today was a productive day, checking a couple things off my list. What I found out today is I do have big aspirations for this porch because it is an important thing that it gets finished for me before winter. I don't know why that necessarily is. I think it's just been several years since we tore off the old porch and we have a new one. Plus, it takes me back to the early phase of our relationship. And it also brings me back to when we bought the house and Caleb wanted to pick me up and walk me across the threshold. And then, like I said, I surrounded it with these flowers that remind me of Toby. And I have Morgana Mums that I planted there for Morgana, our black cat. There's a lot of memories around this porch area, and I don't know why. And there's also the, well, I do know why, but there's also the aspiration of these fun memories that are yet to come that are based around coming and going and guests that we can actually have walk through the front door. I'm just really excited for it, but it's like this bittersweet area of the house at the moment. So actively working on it and changing what it has been into what it will be is, there's a lot of metaphors and symbolism there. I actually got a little teary-eyed while I was working earlier, and I decided that I was going to cut back on my original goals for the day as far as what I wanted to get done, and that's okay. There's still plenty of time in getting this done, and if I just do what I did today in a couple of weeks, it will be done. So with that being said, you guys watched me pick my pickles a couple days ago. I picked some more today. Unfortunately, they are not here. And that is because I put them on the back stoop. I left them unattended and I came back to 3 very happy dogs and the scent of cucumber lingering in the air. My last pickle harvest was destroyed. That's okay. That stuff happens. They were thrilled with the little snacks that they found for themselves. As you can see, our pickles, this is almost obscene. They ran in sizes this year, and with my 2 or 3 pickle vines, I want to say I think I had probably about a dozen pickles that I've hicked. And then there's some started pickles on the line that are just absolutely not going to be good. They will just be tilled back into the garden beds for next year. Why today is exciting for me is I have had these pickling goals for years, ever since I essentially started our family garden. I every year pick up this pickling spice thing as almost like some sort of pressure, like, oh, well, if I have the pickling spice, I don't have an excuse on not to do something. Well, 4 years later, I've never pickled any pickles. I'm going to change that this year. I'm going to enthusiastically use this pickling spice. Originally, I wanted to do 2 varieties. One, just a simple kosher dill with paprika, and then the other one with my annual pickling spice that I pick up. But I'm going to use the spice pack that I have waited so long to use. Well, not waited so long. I pick up one every year. We have so many of them at this point. I think I'm going to cut this in order to use it. So maybe there'll be spears and whole pickles in here, which might make for a disaster. Make spears. How do we make spears? Oh my gosh, it smells so lovely. I think I'm just going to simply quarter them. Let's see how they stack. Well, no, let's get my spices in first. Oh, I don't know what I was expecting. Oh no. Well, we're just gonna commit to it. We're just going to do it. It's an adventure in the kitchen with a learning curve. So I have my whole pickles in here. Okay, so from what I've read, you are supposed to pack your pickles as tight as possible, which is always a good thing to go by. I'm probably not going to use all of this. I have a cup and a half of water. I'm going to add another half cup of vinegar. I'm going to add some cloves of garlic, which reminds me of, there was this one time I was coming back from the hospital 6 or maybe 7 years ago. I was still a little groggy from the anesthesia. I apparently told Caleb that he smells like pickles, which is true. It's more of a garlicky type of scent. It was like this unexpected thing that I said to him that threw him off guard, but it also fed into one of his insecurities. He's afraid of having an unpleasant body odor. So without awareness or sensitivity to the topic, I just blurted it out. And then it became like this inside joke between us. But truth be told, it's like this comforting smell that's just his natural scent. All right, so making the brine with the 2 cups of water, I have added 2 ounces by weight of celery salt. And then I added some healthy grinds of just Himalayan rock salt. I genuinely enjoy celery salt. I love the taste of celery. However, this pickling spice combination, I'm not quite sure how this is going to fare. And now I'm just working to dissolve it. Salty. All right, so we topped it off. My spices are packed. My pickles are packed. All right, so this looks a little nasty. Okay, so I am going to leave this out at room temperature because I don't want the refrigerator to slow down the fermentation process of pickling them. I'm going to come back to these, I think, in a month. So about halfway through my 60-day change your system plan, I will get to try to see how these turned out. Boy, was I surprised about those pickling spices. All right, I think this is where I'm gonna wrap today's vlog. Always remember to keep growing from where you are, and I'll share more with you soon. Tschüss.